Beautiful day on Rocky Hill, and we're here at Punahou School, Hemeter Fieldhouse, for an ILH boys volleyball matchup featuring the Iolani Raiders. And you're Punahou Buff and Blue. I'm Mike Machado, and joining me, as always, former State Player of the Year, Tony McInerney. T-Mac, how are you today?
I'm good. This is wonderful to have an early morning match. We got people filing in. There's a track meet in the back of us.
Busy, busy campus today.
Volleyball in front of us.
But we got ILH volleyball right here. We got Punahou and Iolani. It's cats and dogs right here. So, story on Iolani, they got a new coach.
They got a new coach. Mike Among is still teaching math at Iolani. He's coaching currently his son on the intermediate level, but Carl Relita has taken over the reins.
Right, of course, Mike won a state championship with Iolani in 08. So you lose a coach of that state, you know, you might think of maybe some fall-off potentially. But Iolani always comes very disciplined and very ready to play. So you had a chance to talk to Punahou's setter coach, Charlie Jenkins. If you can briefly tell me what he had to say.
Well, Punahou's Charlie Jenkins setter coach, they came off a pretty tough match, tough loss against Kamehameha last Tuesday. And they had to go back to basics, Michael. They had some individual practices, which is meaning they set up all three nets on this main court right here, and they worked on their middles, their outsides, and their passing.
Right, because Punahou lost to Kamehameha on their home court. Punahou doesn't lose on their home court much at all. Of course, second set, you know, first set was all Punahou. Second set, somebody lit a fire under Kamehameha. You could call it an upset.
It was an upset.
You could call it an upset.
At home, of all the years of me being a part of the Punavision team, I have yet to see Punahou lose at home.
Or the Punahou volleyball family.
Maybe 2009 with Madison McKibben lost to Iolani. But Iolani, I spoke with Randy Nako, and they just came off a great tournament in Maui, and their keys to the match are going to play their game, and serving in is very important. So let's go to the
All right, I am going to get to the starting lineups. Good afternoon, volleyball fans, and welcome to Hemeter Fieldhouse on the campus of Punahou School for this morning's ILH boys varsity volleyball match featuring the Iolani Raiders and the Punahou Buff and Blue. Let's meet the starters. First, for the visiting Raiders, at setter, a 5'8" senior, number 4, Kyle Kekina. At outside hitter, a 5'11" senior, number 7, Andrew Okimura. At outside hitter, a 5'10" senior, number 10, Micah Goshi. At libero, a 5'10" senior, number 11, Alden Wong. At middle, a 6'3" junior, number 12, Preston Kamada. Also at middle, a 6'1" junior, number 14, Ikaika Phillip. And at opposite, a 6'3" senior, number 15, at Travis Cundiff. Head coach for the Raiders is Carl Relita. He's assisted by Jordan Inofuku, Jared Yamamoto, and Randy Nako. And now let's meet the starters for your Punahou Buff and Blue. At libero, a 5'8" junior, number 1, Keikoa Reese. At outside hitter, a 6'6" senior, number 7, Kupono Fay. At middle, a 6'8" junior, number 10, at Danny Andrews. At middle, a 6'3" junior, number 11, Noah Hayashida. At opposite, a 6'3" junior, number 12, Taylor Weens. Setting for Punahou, a 6'3" sophomore, number 13, Micah Ma'a. And at outside hitter for Punahou, a 6'3" junior, number 14, Tui Leta. Head coach for the Buff and Blue is Rick Toon. He's assisted by Brandon Kikuchi, Pono Nuhiva, and Pete Barraza, and Gordon Horiuchi. All right.
Nicely done, Michael. You have the voice, the magic voice, and we're here.
Just lucky. But we are here, yes. And there's Canton Kamatule leading the walk through the line. He's wonder if he'll get any PT today.
Maybe. I've been watching practice. Canton is getting to know the game a little bit better.
Right. He's a big body.
He's a very big body. He's in the weight room doing 225 about 20 times before practice.
And how many sets of that does he do?
Probably
three or four.
My goodness.
Right. And to think he's only a sophomore.
Gosh, he's got potential.
Yeah, he's a healthy boy.
I'm gonna, you know, Mike, this is an interesting little matchup. Punahou has kind of a short week. They had a major match, Kamehameha Tuesday, and now they got Iolani right now. So it's gonna be a barn burner.
Of course, Iolani had a match last night against Hawaii Baptist and lost 2-0 in a packed Hawaii Baptist gym for their annual Spike Night.
Wow.
I guess Hawaii Baptist Academy does a Spike Night.
Okay.
And, of course, you know, Hawaii Baptist is probably one of the top three or four teams in the state.
Mike Fisher. He's going to UCLA. Big body.
Big body. A lot of gifts.
We're getting ready.
Going to join Sean Gruby there?
Sean could, yeah. He's going to be making an impact instantly, I have a feeling.
And we are ready to start. Back to serve for the Raiders, Angie Okimura. Jump floater handled by Faye. Ma'at set outside to Tui off the hands. Set up by Wong. Right side to Cundiff. Reese gets there. Cundiff tries to put down the overpass. Tui trying to find the back corner. No good. Ma'at puts down the overpass.
You know what? First play of the match, we have a pancake. We have a miss hit. Dink, we have an overset smash. Wow.
That's a way to start.
That's a great way to start. That's five plays in one play.
And here we see opening the serving, Punahou's best server, sophomore Micah Ma'a.
I think he's grown a little over the summer.
I think he has. And he's got a few more inches left in him, I think. I mean,
he's got size 14 shoe.
He's going to grow into that. Unfortunately, that just tickles the tape and falls. The Punahou side, we're all even at ones here in the early going.
I'd like to see him maybe have a higher toss on that, take his time. He kind of rushed it, looks like. But it's early, it's only one all.
Back to serve for the Raiders. Libero Alden Wong, handled by Tui. Quick to Noah Hayashida. Hayashida tries to put down the overpass. Raiders scramble for it. Reese, back set to Weens. Wong can't quite get there. He gets his arms on it, but no good. Punahou up 2-1.
Good to see Noah Hayashida getting an early swing established the middle. I'm sure Iolani did not expect that.
Good to see Ma'a trying to mix it up. Tui got a lot of sets against Kamehameha.
He sure did.
There he is with the floater. Kikina quick to the middle. That's off the block and out.
Nice play by the libero, or I'm sorry, whomever passed that. That was a great pass, and number 12 was up on that block, hit Preston Kamada. Nice play.
Kind of a serve handled by Faye. Ma'a with the set back to Faye, cross court off of Wong. Weems tries to put down the overpass. That's Doug Kikina, quick to Preston Kamada. Raiders out to a 3-2 lead.
They aren't showing any fear of being in this gymnasium. That's for sure. Great, great play by Preston Kamada. Nice up
early. It's a small community. Volleyball players know each other. It's kind of handled the serve. Reese handles the serve. Ma'a quick to Tui from the back row. Ma'a again. Faye manages to get the hands and fall down.
Well, they're going to keep going to Tui in the back row, and they're going to try to mix it up as much as they can. Iolani's looking like they're playing some great defense right now.
They're playing inspired. Checking into the game for Cundiff as a defensive specialist, number one Carter Katase, a 5'9" sophomore. And checking into the game for the Buff and Blue, a freshman, 5'2". I think this man has some growing to do as well.
He will.
Young Kelsey Yogi. Kikina back. He calls that in. Micah Goshi with the kill. Iolani has a couple of multi-sport athletes. Goshi and Wong are both basketball players.
That always helps. They're getting their conditioning and cross-training during the whole year, so they're coming in fresh. Nice set by Kyle Kikina. They call
that
an X4. It's a back set, not so towards the pin.
All right. Iolani out to a 4-3 lead in the early stages of set number one. Back to serve Micah Goshi with that last X4 kill. Handled by Reese. Ma'a. Tui out of the back row. That's handled by Katase. Kikina, far side to Okimura. He's blocked by Andrews and Weems.
They were waiting for that, but give credit to Iolani's backcourt for making a heck of a dig. And Kyle Kikina, he flicked that thing nicely out there to the four position, which is an outside set called the four.
Taylor Weems with floater, handled by Wong. Ma'a with the dump. Punahou out to a 5-4 lead.
Being in the front row, Michael's able to have an offensive set mind. And he held his hands high like he was going to set Mike, and he just tapped it over with his left. It's nice. Nice deception.
He has so much game sense.
He does.
He just has, he's such a smart player. Weems with a floater. Handled Kekina. Trying to dump of his own. Handled by Weems. Bump set. Back row to Tui. Handled by Wong. Kekina. Trying it quick to Kamada. That's handled. Reese. Bump set to Tui. Tui pushes it over. Pancake by Wong. Dug by Kekina. Up into the rafters. Wong pushes it over. Weems. Outside to Pono Fei. Off the hands. Handled by Goshi. Andrews tries to put down the overpass. Kekina outside to Okimura, blocked by wow. Andrews.
Rally of the tourney, I'm sorry, of the game. That was fantastic. I didn't think that ball would not hit the big fans that we have up there. Great play.
That's right. We had one in the last match that clattered around in the fans up there. Pono out to a 6-4 lead. Leans with a serve. Wong. Kekina quick to Okimura off the high hands, dug by Tui. Ma'a with the set. Back to Weens. He hits Wong.
Well, you know, Micah is in the front row, and Taylor Weems is the opposite setter. So what he did was set a back row set called a D, which is behind the setter. He's got to jump in back of the 10-foot line, miss hit.
The D set is if the opposite's taking off from behind the 3-meter line?
Correct, yes.
All right. There's a serve by Dennis Yee. Ma quick to Andrews off of Carter Kataze's chest and down. Point buff and blue.
They had two up on Andrews, but Andrews being 6'8". He's just going over people.
Look how much more growing that boy has.
Probably going to grow in girth. He's going to put on a couple pounds, lift some weights, get a little bit more pounds on his body.
There we see the University of Hawaii bound Kupono Fei. Ripping the serve, handled by Goshi. Kekina outside to Okimura, handled by Reese. Ma'a in the front row tries to take a swing at it, handled by Katase. Goshi puts it over. Ma'a outside to Tui. Wong handles it into the net. Bumped over by Phillip. Nice scramble by Iolani. Ma'a back row to Weens again. He hits Wong.
This is shaping up to be something special.
Iolani keeping themselves in the game. Don't hit out. Punahou's hit out the last 2 points. You don't want to play within yourselves. Isn't that what Coach Nako said?
Big
Coach
time.
Randy said.
And it looks like they're playing within themselves. Number 11, Alden Wong, is coming up some brilliant plays.
See Kekina with a floater, handled by Fei. Ma'a outside to Tui, through the block. Oh, dug by Kekina, nicely done. Fade. Wong set to Goshi, through Lean's hands. And the Raiders even it up. Tony, there's a game going on here.
This is a gamer. It's 7-7. Punahou Gym. I think people are going to hear the crowds from the track and come on down here and watch.
We can hope. We can hope. It's a busy day for Punahou students. There's the junior function tonight. ILH relays up on the track currently.
Okay.
So Kekina with the serve. Fei quick to Andrews. Blocked Zoe. Andrew Okimura. Raiders are feeling it, T-Mac.
They are feeling it. They looks as though, Mike, that they have a good scouting report. You know, any good pass early, they're going to the middle, and they commit block, committing on their middle. Nice block.
Say Kekina. Handled by Fei. Outside to Tui, and he's blocked by Cundiff. Two blocks in a row for the Raiders. They're feeling it. Coach June thinking about a timeout anytime soon?
9-7. I don't think so yet. He'll pull a
another
Phil Jackson.
Maybe get up. So Al Skates was a master of that.
Yeah,
getting
he
up
was.
And kind of killing time. Reese back to Andrews. Kekina can't quite handle it. Point to the buff and blue.
Interesting. I'm looking across at the bench at Rick and Brandon and Pono. Their body language is fine. They never
still
panic.
Very early.
Yeah.
Let's see. Reese with a jump spinner. Kekina. Back set to Okimura off of Tui's hands. Phillip tries to put down the overpass. Reese bumps it out. Point Raiders.
Ikaika Phillip made a great play. Instead of him trying to go full arm swing and bury that thing, Mike, he went with a two-hand stuff, which keeps him out of the net.
Very heady play. Jump serve from Okimura, handled by Fei. Overpassed. Ma'a keeps it in play. Back set to Weens again. It's handled by Okimura. Three balls it over. Reese. Quick set from Ma'a to Hayashida. Punahou's into the net. He's into the net. No, they call Iolani into the net. Be a point for the Buff and Blue.
Looks like this Iolani team is ready for the battle, and their defense has been exemplary.
Handled by Okimura. Kekina outside to Goshi. Kekina looking backside to Cundiff. That's handled by Kaponofe. That's going over the net. Micah Goshi puts down the overpass. Point Raiders.
Well, the defense on Puno and their and their serve receive is a little bit, getting a little bit too tight for Micah. He's had, Micah, I'm sorry. He's had to struggle with those tight passes.
Here you see Alden Wong, the Iolani libero, back to serve. He floats it over, handled by Reese. Outside, Taylor Weens with a kill. That's tried to push back over by Cundiff. Three ball, Reese, Ma'a, back set to Fay through the block, point Buffin Blue.
Well, they're going with that BIC called, it's a back row quick, condensed version called a BIC, which is out of the middle position behind the 10-foot line.
Good. As opposed to the pipe, which is a higher set. A
little higher set, the pipe. It's the evolution of the pipe.
Tui with the floater. Kekina back outside to Goshi. He finds the line.
Well, they had their matchup, you know, Taylor Ween, I'm sorry, well, Iolani had the nice matchup, one hitter against one blocker. Usually the hitter's gonna win that.
And here you see Carter Katase checking in for the Raiders, back to serve. Iolani up by two, set number one. Ponofe with the serve, handles the serve, back outside to Faye, trying to find the line.
In, nice high hit in. That's a lot of work for a big kid, 6'6". He's passing a perfect ball, and then he's got to get outside, hit that go ball. They call it a go ball, shooting to the pin or the antenna.
Well, that's what Kamehameha was trying to do a lot in the last match, just punish Tui and Kupono, make them serve and make them handle a serve, receive, and hit everything. There's outside to Goshi, and he's blocked by Andrews and Weens. Quinho bringing its own block party to A2 tonight.
12 all, yes they are. I would suggest him to hit down the line. Going into the meat of the block, which is a 6'8 stud, that's tough.
See Yogi with a serve. Kekina from way beyond the three-point line. Okimura hits into the net. Point Buffin Bluen put him out to a one-point lead.
13-12, I don't think they've led much
since,
in this match. Since 2-1.
I want to say like 6-4. 6-4, yeah. Somewhere in there. 4-4 maybe, 4-3. That's outside to Goshi.
He is not afraid to challenge the block. Some hitters, you know, I've seen is they try to avoid the block, thus they create some errors. He's just challenging, hitting right into the
there
heart.
You saw, and you saw him there going into the meat of the block and using the block. I mean, Goshi's listed at 5'10", going up against a 6'8", 6'3 block. And if you hit smart, you can still win the point.
You can chisel.
There's a point handled by Tui outside of Kupono Fay. Like a Goshi can't handle it with a chicken wing. Yeah, point to the Buffin Blue.
That's a hard, high, deep hit. We like, as a coach, I like to see my kids hitting high and deep. That's the money ball.
You see, Ponofe, obviously, he's an athlete, but he's gotten bigger and stronger, and he looks much better from last year. And here you see checking for Ponofe. Trent Thompson with a serve. Kamado's blocked, handled by Wong. Reese. Ma'a with the set to Ponofe down the line. Point Buffin Blue.
That was nice. That was in rhythm, in system. Everything was well functioning.
How you draw it up?
Well, you get a perfect pass right there, and then Micah disguises him, setting to Andrews. They have to jump with Andrews, and then they shoot it out to Ponofe.
Thompson with the serve, and he hits Katase up high. Couldn't quite get out of an out ball.
Yeah, this could be a possible timeout, I'm feeling.
There it is.
And there it is, yeah.
Coach Carl, seen enough. He had a 2-3-point lead. Now we have a 5-point swing there. Punahou up 16-13, halfway through set number one. Iolani's managing to keep it competitive.
Yeah, they have. It's only 16-13 with no time limit. So, you know, anything can happen. This was a good timeout, I think. You don't want to get it to 17, 18, 13.
Right. You don't want, once, you know, Punahou gets that fourth point, they get the fifth point, and next thing you know, it could be 6 or 7. And even if you call it at 5.
Correct.
There's a good time to burn it. I mean, match against Kamehameha this last Tuesday, T-Mac, Punahou looked so good.
They did.
In that first game. I think Paul Honda in the newspaper said they looked elegant even.
Ha.
Which I've never seen. Which
right.
Is wonderful.
I mean, they did. They did.
They looked fantastic. But then in that second set, you know, Kamehameha came out, played some very inspired ball. So this is not over. I mean,
by any
stretch of the imagination, Iolani's a very scrappy and well-coached team. You know, they're not going to match up size-wise against Punahou, but if they play smart and Punahou doesn't come to play, they could win this.
Correct. And I'm looking at Kyle Kakina. He's a true leader right now. He's getting these guys inspired.
So Kakina, back set to Goshi, no block, and he hits way wide.
That was a well-drawn-up play. That was a back row attack D position, and there was no block up, but that is a hard ball to connect with.
That's 4 points in a row for Thompson, and he hits into the net. The Raiders given 4 points away on Thompson's serve. You see checking back into the match for the Raiders, defensive specialist Dennis Yee, 5'6" senior, to serve for the Raiders. Down 14-17, Buff and Blue home court, that's handled by Tui. Ma'o, the set outside to Kaponofei, off the hands and out, point to the Buff and Blue.
Smart hit. You know, Kyle Kakina is a really good jumper. He's not listed probably above 5'10". 6'6 against 5'10", I think the 6'6 is going to win that battle. Well,
Kikina's listed at 5'8", and that might
5'8",
be...
5'8", there you have it.
And that could be generous.
Yeah.
Good to see Kaponofei getting involved in the match, set number one. Nice serve handled by Micah Goshi. Kikina chases it down. Okimura gets it over. Reese. Tui. Faye gets it over. Kikina out. Oh, looking middle to Phillip. He gets it through the block. He's calling a lift on Tui. A point to the Raiders.
They're running that one ball, which is the quick set to the middle called the one, but it's a little bit delayed on the Iolani's behalf. Might be giving Andrews a little bit of timing trouble on his block.
So Kikina with the serve handled by Faye. Ma'a outside to Tui, quickly down the line. This is what happens when Punahou's in rhythm. We've
yes.
seen this a few points now, a couple from Kaponofei, and now Tui's in the front row.
He likes to bury that down the line, and with his quarterback arm strength.
He's gotten much, much stronger since last year, Tony.
Oh, yeah.
You see Reese gets it over. Kikina looking at quick to Phillip. That's blocked, handled by Cundiff. Okimura free balls it over. Kaponofei. Ma'a back set to Trent Thompson. Handled by Wong. A bump set, Kikina in the middle. Wong's going to free ball that over. Thompson, Ma'a quick to Hayashida, handled by Ma'a. Reese free ball. Hayashida free ball. Kikina outside to Okimura. Blocked by Ma'a. Kikina back set to Cundiff. Roofed by Hayashida and Tui.
So Tui's getting excited. That was a straight down roof. In fact, the ball landed before the hitter actually landed on the Iolani side. That's called straight down.
Not coming back as Punahou's extended to a 5-point lead now.
Well, Mike, they hit the magic number 20, and usually the team that gets there first more than likely wins.
Would take a significant run. Nice serve by Reese. Well handled by Okimura. Running a combo play, Okimura free balls it over. They're calling a net violation on Punahou. The point to the Raiders.
Well, it looks like they're doing a double, some kind of a combination. The one goes in front, and then somebody comes around. Iolani's looking no worse for wear. They're playing well still. Even though down, that's a bummer serve.
Right. Okimura into the low part of the net. And Punahou's best server, Micah Ma'a, sophomore. All ILH, all state selection. Last year, Kikina outside to Goshi. Off the high hands, chased down by Faye. Ma'a to set outside to Tui. Looking cross court, he hits wide.
That was a scramble play by Kupono. Nice, you know, it was just a miss hit. He went for the heavy extreme angle, what we call the wrist away, when he's trying to hit wrist away. I like to see him challenge the block maybe on that one.
You see Wong, handled by Reese. Ma'a with the set, back row to Kaponofei. Wong handles it, but Iolani can't keep it in play. It'll be a point to the Buff and Blue. 3 points away from winning set number one, and Iolani takes its second
timeout.
Probably a good call.
Yeah, I think Iolani's serve is not giving Punahou as much problems as it did earlier. Once they have a good, any team, when you pass well, you can run your offense.
That's the holy trinity of volleyball.
Yes.
Good pass begets a good set, begets a good swing.
Right, and it's overstated, obviously, serving and passing, but for all you listeners out there, kids or adults that are getting your son or daughter involved in volleyball, get them going on a nice serve and have them pass a lot of balls.
Because if you can pass, you know, Hawaii's not known for breeding guys that are 6'8". Yes, we have Daniel Andrews.
Right.
But Hawaii's not producing a lot of 6'6", 6'8 guys. But you know what? If you're 6'2 and you can pass, they're going to find a place for you on the floor.
Oh, yes. And beyond the
high school
ILH high school, they'll go NCAA.
Right.
Nice to see the band here, Michael. And
the multi-generational and the next generation get
this
shake on. Is that a little bit of robot?
That was called a get down. He's getting down.
Right.
Well, we got 22-17, Michael. And,
that's right. You see a few athletes from other sports trickling in. There's, as I mentioned before, ILH relays happening on upper field right now at the track. Athletes from other schools trickling in. Tui with a serve. Goshi, Kekina, looking outside to Goshi. Reese can't handle it. Point to the Raiders.
Wow, he's amazing. He's only 5'10". He's crushing it inside the block of Trent. And that's not easy to do. My goodness, so nice play.
You see Carter Katase with the serve, handled by Faye. Ma'a, Tui, Katase can't get their point, buff and blue.
They were dug in on their heels, and Tui, smart enough, does a little change-up.
Kind of pulled the string on that
right.
one a little bit.
Like a breaking ball and pitching.
Change-up.
Change-up, you know. He went full arm swing, and right at the end, he just held
just
up.
Just snapped, pulled back a little bit.
Nice shot.
You see the young freshman, Kelsey Yogi. Nice serve, Mr. Yogi. Kekina outside to Goshi. Is that going to be handled by Tui? They're going to call Punahou into the net. Point to the Raiders.
I think he's going to get a lot more sets as well. It's 23. It's 19 serving 23. He's going to be getting a lot of sets this year. Nicely done by him. Little ball change here, Mike. Ball
Goshi wants something a little drier.
Yeah.
You ever deal with a lot of ball slippage?
Yeah, there's a, you know, I was a setter. Sometimes I've had guys wipe their forearms with the ball and then serve it. So, you know, the setter might be messed up.
Let's see. Okimura trying to get the hands. Handled by Reese nicely. Tui bump set to Faye through Okimura's hands. Long can't get there. Point to the buff and blue. We're at set point.
That was a miscue for sure. Nice save by Kekoa Reese. And looks like it's set point right now.
Trent Thompson with the floaty. Long, Kekina back set to Kamada. That's handled. Andrews wins the joust in that. Ma'a and Andrews stare at each other and it drops.
You got it. I got it. Who got it? No one does.
Campfire.
That happens a lot when you don't open your mouth in volleyball. It's important to be vocal, Michael.
That's right. It. Fortunately, at 24-19, not a big deal. They can smile about it. See Yi with the serve. Ma'a trying to throw it over. Andrews trying to push over the overpass, and he's well into the net.
Yeah.
That's kind of an awkward angle there. See Coach Toon's going to call a timeout, kind of reset the troops here. Doesn't want Iolani to get any momentum.
Good timeout. No need. You know, you can't carry your timeouts into the second set, so you might as well use two. 24, 21, 21 serving 24.
Well, this happened in the match against Kamehameha on Tuesday. Punahou had a significant lead.
Right,
it was
they
a 12-point lead in game in set number one, and that number shrunk quickly because Punahou just felt like they're, okay, we got 10, 12 points to burn.
We're fine, yeah,
then,
we're fine, boom.
And then Rick had to call a timeout at 19 or 20, and then, okay, they got the next point. All right, let's move on now.
Well, I think Rick is telling the team right now, you see the huddle, let's just get a pass. I'm thinking, since Andrews made that mistake, he net on that ball, I'd like to see him get set to redeem himself. Wouldn't be surprised if they get a good pass and they run
a
one.
Yes, exactly.
Let's see if I'm a soothsayer.
Prescient.
a clairvoyant.
And a bunch of other words we have trouble spelling.
I go to Google.
Thank you, Siri. There's the serve handled by Tui. Ma'a with a dump, point Buff and Blue, set number one, Buff and Blue 25-21.
You know, that's not an easy play for Tui, first of all, to make by passing that overhead right to the spot and then Micah timing it to dump that with his left hand. That's not easy.
Well done. You can tell, I mean, Micah Ma'a is a sophomore this year, and he was All-State last year. All-ILH. And he's only going to get better. This is still, you know, it's a very competitive Punahou team, but this team's loaded with juniors. I mean, Kupono Faye's going to be gone, and Scotty Paris is going to be gone. But
there's, you know, the JV, Danny McInerney and I are coaching a
JV Gold. That's right.
And the JV Blue has a lot of sophomore talent. We have a lot of freshman talent. So the system still turns.
Right. Just cranks it out. I mean, the ILH... It's no mystery. Volleyball in Hawaii is the ILH is where the competition is. 1979 was the last time a non-ILH team won the state title. Roosevelt had won three in a row.
Yep.
That was the last time. And of course, last year, Kamehameha Hawaii, on the back of Evan Enriquez, got to the state final.
Right, that was tough.
Gave Punahou a good rub.
Good run.
And, you know, he was still named, he wasn't on the winning team, but was still named most outstanding player of the tournament.
That guy is awesome. That guy, 6 foot, he can jump well. Crazy.
Right. So, but traditionally, the cradle of power is in the ILH.
Yes.
I mean, for many, many, I mean, it's...
Yes.
Punahou has won 30 of the 44... state championships
there, yeah.
Contested. So you can, you know, easy math on that is about three quarters of that.
70.
Six of the last eight.
Wow.
So it's not necessarily unheard of for other teams to win, but, you know, boys volleyball in Hawaii, the conversation usually starts and ends with Punahou.
It sure does. And Iolani is no slouch either. They're,
no. State title in 08.
Yeah, with Brad Lawson. They beat Punahou with Madison McKibben and Taylor Crabb. Right. Whom all are, Brad's in Germany, Madison's at USC, Taylor Crabb is having a phenomenal year at Long Beach State. He's getting about 45 attempts a game.
And he's not that big. He's about, what,
6'1".
Six one.
He's jumping about 41 vertical.
Buck 50 soaking wet.
Yeah, he's jumping about 41 inches. He can slam dunk, two hands, no problem.
Wow.
He won the dunk contest his senior year.
That's
in
right.
In basketball.
Of course. Yeah. Of course. Yeah, I remember he was a judge a couple of years ago when he was back on the... and there you see the next generation of Kamatule. Yeah. Young Falcon wearing the Raiders hat as a manager kind of sliding in behind the huddle there.
Okay.
Next generation of growing Kamatules.
Wouldn't be surprised if Iolani comes out to a little bit of a lead. You know, they're playing some inspired ball.
Well, I imagine Punahou's coaching staff is going to get in their ear at this point and say, don't let what happened last Tuesday happen again. Don't let that happen. Don't let them feel like they can get into this match.
Let's see how they respond to the challenge here. You know, a lot of times teams in general, they win a first set, what was it, 25-22? That's pretty tight.
21, yeah. But
25-21. And there's always some kind of a let up for some. It's like the.
Yeah, Iolani got out to a lead at around
the
6.
Mystery.
Oh, and here we go. Second set. Ma'a with the serve. Kekina back to Cundiff. Dug up by Faye. Pushed over by Thompson. And that's just wide out. That was very close, Tony.
Very close.
That
good
was
call
very close.
By lines judge Sam Mukai. That was about probably 2 inches out.
Inches.
Yeah.
Inches wide. See Wong with the serve, Tui. Quickly from Ma'a to Noah Hayashida. Noah Hayashida seen some sets in this one. That's nice.
Yeah, it's good to get him involved for the anytime you have a well-run middle, everything seems to open
fall
up
into
nicely.
Place.
Yeah.
And that all starts with a nice pass.
Tui. I don't know why they're serving Tui. Tui is a little bit too good for the pass. I think they're picking on him. He's in the front row, Mike. So when you serve a front row player, he's got a pass and he might not get the set because he's out of position. So that's a good call possibly.
Right. Trying to push him back.
Push him back.
have a longer approach, wear him out a little bit. Yep. But, you know, he's 16.
I don't think they get tired, yeah. Do they?
Kikina. You see Kamada's block by Thompson and Hayashida.
Trent Thompson, that's a – they tried a three set there to Preston Kamada, and the three set is kind of an extended version of a one.
You see Tui serving well long.
I think it almost hit the blue curtain on the fly.
That hit – that would have been out on the basketball court.
Yes.
That was out.
It was in the gym.
It was – yes.
That's what we say. That was in the gym.
Glad the curtain's down. Glad the curtain's down. You see a substitution, subbing Travis Cundiff out for Carter Katase, defensive specialist, 5'9", sophomore.
I believe
Raiders.
Tyler Cundiff is his brother going to USC.
I'm going to say Thompson hit into the net. Four contacts. Point for the Raiders, a 3-2 in the early going of set number two.
Well, let's see if my prediction comes true. 3-2 early lead.
Ioane needs to come out on fire.
Well, they need to win this set or they're going
to go home. Of course, ILH first round, best 2 out of 3. Three balled over by Thompson, by Wong. Kekina quickly to Kamada off the high hands. Thompson, Ma'a pushing it outside to Pono Fei. Through the block, finds the open space in the corner. Point up the blue.
Nice hit, not the best set. It's a very hittable ball.
Cupono, it was a very safe set.
Very safe set, not tight at all. A little bit inside. It helps that Cupono 6'6".
It does.
Can't teach height. I know we've said that, but it is quite true.
Kelsey Yogi. Second serve in a row, touches the tape. Kamada outside to Goshi, and he hits that into the net.
That was a little bit of an offset by Kyle Kikina. He knows it. Right when it came out of his hands, I could see the grimace on his face.
That's not going to work. As
my
a
bad,
setter, you know that,
you
right, when it's leaving
bad,
your hands.
Bad. Yeah.
It's
foot fault.
Called by one of our linesmen. All right.
It's Cupono's dad, I believe.
That's right.
Kyle Fei. Nice serving by the young lad, Yogi. He's got a nice little jump serve.
Future libero in training for the Buff and Blue. Does Goshi serve into the net? Not going to keep yourself in the match, hitting into the net.
You can't knock him. He is going all out. He gets an A for effort. He's involved in almost every play.
Thompson by Katase. Quickly to Cundiff. Thompson can't handle it. Excuse me, that was Kamada. We're all even at fives. Set number two.
Nice setting by young Kyle Kikina. He knows what he's doing. He has a brother, Kayshawn, that played at Iolani. Father, dad, Wayne Kikina, plays a lot of beach volleyball.
Former partner of yours, I understand.
Former partner of mine. We played in multiple games together.
You see Trent Thompson cross court. Nicely done. Like those odds with no block.
No block, is it helps. Even though it's behind the 10-foot line, it still gives you so much range. And they did take out Taylor Weens, put in Trent Thompson, something new. Fresh legs.
Wrinkle, Trent Thompson, yep. Also a junior. Junior heavy team for the Buff and Blue. It's Pono Fei.
Miss hit.
That one manages to stay in the gym as well. Not in the court of play, unfortunately.
We call that a spader.
A spader?
Spader. That's the volleyball terminology. When you hit it, it's got a little backspin, and sometimes it stays in, but it's called a spader.
Handled by Reese. Ma'a quickly to Andrews. Iolani defense scrambling. Free balled over by Kikina. Fei. Ma'a outside to Tui. One block. Wow. Handled by Wong. Nicely done. Cundiff tries to push it over. Andrews to Tui. Wong back set to Goshi, blocked by Andrews and Ma'a. They're waiting on that.
Okay, 6-6. People coming in. Sorry, 7-6. This is high level volleyball. No holds barred knockout.
That's
drag
right.
Out.
And after this, speaking of high level volleyball, we got Clash of the Titans coming up.
Oh yes.
In early April, 5 and 6.
Right.
We haven't got to, I've been aching to do the put home Mira, we got the MiraCosta match this
we
year,
got the
my
Mira,
friend.
nice.
Me and T-Mac on the MiraCosta
right
match.
I think that's the fifth
Friday.
Friday,
the late match on Friday.
Please tune in to Puna Vision Sports 2013. It's going to be a heck of a season for Yuri Biersock, our executive producer.
A lot of Puna Vision just growing by leaps and bounds.
Big time. Well-run operation.
Since Yuri's arrival. It's a serve by Okimura. Ma'a back set to Thompson, trying to go down the line. He hits wide. Iolani out to an 8-7 lead.
You know, that's a hard shot. He's got one block up. He's trying to cut it down the line. Just hit the meat of the court, which is the cross-court ball, cross-body.
Okimura with the serve, handled by Tui. Ma'a back to Tui. Trying to nudge it cross-court by Wong. Iolani can't keep it in play. Be a point to the Buff and Blue. We're all even at eights.
Alden Wong is stepping into that angle. He's had several digs of that nature. Unfortunately, no one could get around and set that ball.
Michael with the floaty. Handled by Wong outside to Doshi. Thompson trying to chase it down. And right into our floor cameraman,
nice set
Andrew
by,
Ryan.
Nice set by Kyle Kakina. The kid's got some paws.
He does. Is that what they call it, paws?
Paws is your hands when you set. You know, if you've got good paws, you can dish the nectar.
All right.
I'm giving you a little bit of volleyball terminology.
I appreciate it. There's Wong pushing it outside to Kunda. He goes high hands for the point. Iolani out to a two-point lead, teammate.
They're fired up, 10-8, nothing to lose. Game to 25, no time limit.
As there is in the intermediate games.
Yes, there are, intermediate games.
Wong with the serve handled by Reese. Ma'a back set to Tui, just trying to push it over the block, handled by Kundit. Kakina chases it down, back outside to Goshi. Looking to go high hands, blocked by Thompson and Hayashida. Kakina back set to Kundit, and he's roofed by Tui.
Nice lateral movement by Noah Hayashida. Kyle Kakina was all the way over in the left area, and he goes against the grain and sets a back five.
Hayashida was covering a lot of ground.
That's about 18 feet in 2 seconds.
Tui serving short. Wong runs up to handle it. Kakina's trying to get to Goshi. Iolani has to free ball it over, and it's hit wide. Point to the Buff and Blue.
10 all. You're not seeing the fire in Punahou's eyes as much as the Iolani's fire. I wonder if that will play into something soon.
Handled by Wong. Kakina outside to Goshi. Reese, one-arm dig. Does not stay in play. Nice try by Yonke Kolarus.
Yeah, that's a good spot. Micah Goshi is hitting a hard angle. Maybe Punahou could adjust, move that block in. See what happens if Rick will adjust to that.
See, Katase back to serve for the Raiders. He floats it over. Reese lets it go long wisely. We're all even at 11s.
Haven't seen many errors by Iolani on their serve. That's tough serving. You don't mind it when it goes deep out. It always hurts when it serves in the net.
Why is that?
Well, you have to play the ball always if it's going out. You don't know if it's in or out. If it's in the net, it's automatic.
You force the receiver to make a decision.
Correct.
Trent Thompson, awkward ball handling error there. He and Danny Andrews getting in each other's way.
A little miscue.
Excellent point to make, T-Mac.
Yeah.
Educating our audience.
Thank you. It's interesting how things play out in the middle of a match. You think about something, you don't do one thing, and it just bites you.
Goshi, tough serve handled by Kaponofei. Ma'a back set to Tui. One arm dig by Goshi. Kakina back to Goshi from the back row. Gets it off the tape. Well in for Micah Goshi. Good job.
I was going to say the luck of the Irish. It is St. Paddy's Day tomorrow, but the luck of Micah Goshi. That's a taper.
He's doing everything on that one.
That's the taper.
Tough serve. Gets the set. Ma'a quickly to Andrews. Handled by Wong. Kakina back set to Goshi. Off of Thompson's hands, Ma'a. No one chasing it down for the Buff and Blue. Raiders out to a three-point lead, T-Mac.
14-11.
We saw this, and this looks very similar to the last game.
Very similar, and a timeout by Coach Toon.
Iolani's starting to feel a little bit of momentum here, possibly.
Oh, yeah. I see Rick Toon is, he keeps it calm, cool, stoic. You got Pono Nuhiva, here's Rick, exhorting his team on. Basically, Michael, there's a communication breakdown in that type of a play.
Not the first time we've seen two of ball drop.
Yeah, that's third time this match. So somebody's got to just step and say, hey, I got it. Or the guy that digs it, the boy that digs it, has to say a name, anybody's name, and set the ball. Just to keep everybody on the same page.
Call somebody's name out. Make them accountable for it.
Trent, set. Right? Cupono, set. So they're calling me.
And entertaining the crowd. We'll send him out. We should send him out there during the game breaks.
He's the rubber band man.
Of Punahou School.
Yeah. Alan Hackbarth, Jr. That guy is amazing. And the stand sheriff.
Still at
are
it.
You kidding
Wise
me?
Move by Coach Charlie to get Alan some tickets. Goshi with a serve handled by Reese. Bump set from Ma to Thompson. Welcome to Go High Hands. Andrews, Dewey. Thompson hits wide. Another point for the Raiders. Out to a four-point lead.
Don't be surprised if Rick makes a little sub change, gets Taylor Weens back in. Trent's having a little bit of a problem on that overhead.
Well, we saw in the last match, he subbed in Dylan Girard at that opposite spot.
Right.
And kind of went with the two-setter thing. Pono Faye tried to bump it over.
No.
That falls in front of Carter Katase.
He tried for the pancake, which is spreading your hand flat on the ground, keeping your hand flat.
What do you look for when the ball pops up to know the guy got there?
You look at the trajectory of the ball coming off and see how that's spinning.
Katase, Kikina has to chase it down. Goshi free balls it over. Another communication error there from the Buffalo Blue.
Tough play, wasn't the best pass. Maybe he could have, Micah could have set the high ball on the outside. He knows it, he's a veteran. He's been playing for years and years, so he's just gonna go right back to rhythm. Probably gonna go a nice outside set to Cupono.
E with the serve, Reese. Ma'a trying to dump, he hits into the net. Here you see Rick doing his best Al Skates impression, getting up to, am I gonna call a timeout? Am I not gonna tell him? The official has to look at him, there's a pause. E with the serve. Nice pass by Tui. Ma'a looking outside to Cupono Faye, blocked by Kekina. Ma'a back row to Tui. He's looking for that, looking cross court.
Wow.
Iolani fans behind us thinking it was out.
Wow.
Kyle Faye called it in.
That wasn't the most crisp play I've seen.
It wasn't the most graceful looking swing I've seen him take, but it went in.
Here's what happens when you're in this, involved in this type of game. The mindset, you're down 17-13 in your gym. Things become a little bit more pressurized, so you kind of tense up a lot.
See Pono Faye with the serve. Punahou down by four in their own gym. Handled by Wong. Kikina back row to Goshi. Off of Tui's hands, back in. Outside Wong. Outside to Okimura, handled by Tui. Ma'a back outside to Tui. Off the hands and out. Point to Buff and Blue.
Kyle Kikina wanted all of that. He knew he had Tui. He's a comical young guy. I've known the kid since he was born.
Since
forever. He's a classic.
Another tough serve from Faye. Handled by Katase. Kikina back set to Phillip. Bump set to Faye. Kikina pushes it over. Free ball. Thompson. Ma'a looking outside to Tui. Off the block, Andrews, Reese, bump set to Tui. He's got a free ball that over, handled by Wong. Kikina looking back row to Goshi. He hits into the net and out. Tony's calling a touch.
I saw
Up
a
official
touch.
Dan Hironaka.
I saw a touch.
Agreeing.
I'm surprised this bench didn't erupt. That was a definite touch. Who am I to say?
Who are you? Dan Hironaka's the official. You are not. He's saying, Tony, put your hands down, young man.
Well, we 17-15. Iolani didn't want them to tie this game up, so good timeout.
Good timeout. So Iolani's got out to a lead. They had a 4 or 5 point lead there for a little bit. Rick Toon called a timeout at 14-11. Punahou's got it now to a 2 point lead at 15. 2 point deficit. Iolani up by 17-15, Buff and Blue up by 1-9.
Looks as though the Iolani side, looks as though Rick Toon is very, very intense. He's an intense guy.
Yes.
He's a very good coach, well-run operation. He, all his P's and Q's, all his I's are dotted.
Very meticulous.
Very meticulous. I love that about Rick. He's got good preparation.
Attention to detail.
Big time.
Steve. Former Punahou stand-up, former University of Hawaii stand-up back in the day.
And then his fifth year, he ended up at Pepperdine. Classic
honestly,
story.
That place has never rocked as it did in the late 90s with the UH men.
Oh, true that.
You see Ponofei with a tough serve. Tui puts down the overpass, handled by Wong. Kikina chases down, looking back set to Goshi. Handled by Reese. Bump set to Tui. Faye's got a free set it over, handled by Phillip. Kikina quickly to Okimura, off the high hands. Reese can't get there. Triple block waiting. Very smart swing by Andrew Okimura.
Triple block playing. That's an old school call we call an X2. Basically, the left front comes in right off of the quick set, the one, and hits a two right off the net.
Iolani back out to a three-point lead, 18-15. Down one set to none on Punahou's home floor. The setter, Kyle Kikina, with the floater. Handled by Reese. Ma'a outside to Tui, down the line. No question about that.
He hit that low seam between 14 and 11. I'm sorry, Ikaika Phillip. And help me now, seven. Andrew Okimura. That's a nice hit by Tui. He's got good vision. Good vision.
Barely.
Yeah.
Barely. You hit 40, flip a switch, things start breaking.
Right.
Kikina quickly to Phillip. Nicely done.
Two up on that block where the left front is helping with the middle. The middle's a little bit late. That one good tip shot over to area.
Very smartly done by Ikaika Phillip.
Cerebral, very cerebral.
You see Okimura, 5'11" senior, back to serve, and he sails that long. That was ducking. You know, Reese was going to let that go, and then by the time it went out, it wasn't out by much.
That was dropping. They had some major topspin, out by about 2 inches.
Ma'a with the serve, handled by Goshi nicely. Kikina looking back outside to Goshi, off the high hands. Reese gets a hand on it. Tui with the set. Faye from the back row. He's looking for the touch. He's not going to get it. Faye hits into the net. Raiders first to 20, T-Mac.
Magic 20. Four hits on that. Kupono, good swing. He does not show fear. He swings away.
Punahou not rolling opponents as they have in the past. They've lost a number of sets this year. I mean, they lost the set to Marinole early in the year. Of course, they lost the set to... You see Wong doing a nice job of chasing that down. Is Okimura going to get that over?
Out.
But out.
Out.
Chasing that down, Okimura. But as I was saying, Punahou's not exactly rolling through opponents this year. They're playing a little loose.
They are. You know, it's interesting to see this team is Micah and Tui have played together for years. They'll steady out. That's a dump. That's a slam dump dunk. Set up by a great serve from Tui.
Buffen Blue closes to one, 19-20. Buffen Blue down by one, their home court. Floated by Tui, trying to pull Wong up. We'll call that technically that's an ace.
That's an ace. You know, you're not going to make a play on that. 20 all now.
Notice
footsteps.
Number of times now that Tui served short, trying to pull the Iolani libero up to handle that. Alden Wong, Kikina outside to Goshi, through the block, handled by Tui. Bump set by Reese. Faye's going to get a swing at it, Reese. Ma'a quickly to Tui. Kikina chases it down. Outside to Goshi, off of Thompson's hands, handled by Faye. Thompson has to free ball it over. Little communication there. Kikina outside to Goshi again, off of Thompson's hands. They're going to call Thompson under the net, point to the Raiders.
Heck of a rally. That could be a tide changer, 21-20. We'll see.
Punahou was on a three-point run there.
The upstart Iolani playing tough away from their gym. Great energy level by them.
Tough serve by Katase, handled by Reese. Ma'a looking outside to Ponofei, handled by Wong. Tui, Ma'a with a set back outside to Ponofei, off the hands. Wong gets one hand on it. Great dig by Alden Wong. Okimoto's free balling it over. Tui to Ma'a, outside to Ponofei again, dug by Okimura, point to the Buffen Blue.
Kupono Fay is going to get a great meal after this because he's burning a lot of calories. He's hitting a lot of balls.
I don't know how much dancing he's going to do. Oh, that's right. He's not a junior
anymore.
He's
a senior. He might be going.
He's
who knows?
I don't believe so.
Maybe a nap and a turkey sandwich is in order after that. That's a heck of a rally. Libero, Alden Wong is a gamer, we call
you
them.
You see both sides trying to get create a little bit of time, get a little break. Iolani's wiping up some wet spots on the floor. Coach Toon using the opportunity.
Right. The mystery wet spot when there isn't, when you're down or tied up late.
The officials will let that go sometimes. You see Yogi with a serve. Goshi with the hammer, Micah Goshi. Iolani crowd giving it up.
My goodness, this kid is pounding. Who is this guy? He's playing a heck of a match.
Fire is Micah Goshi.
Five.
Raiders up by one, 3 points away from evening this match up.
That's inside the block and straight down. He's going to earn a turkey sandwich too after that. My goodness.
Goshi with a serve. Reese chases it down. Bumps it to Thompson. He just bumps it over the block. Pancake dig from the Raiders. Free balled over by Wong. Thompson. Ma'a looking quickly to Andrews through Katase's hands. Buff and Blue even it up.
Wow, that's a tough
break. Rally. Tough break for the Raiders.
Number one, Carter Katase, he knows his, you know, when you want to make that dig, you got to create a ball-shaped hand pattern. So you almost catch it and throw it back up. His hands were a little bit too wide. Ball-shaped hands.
Optimal distance between your fingers,
correct.
Mr. Sutter.
Yeah.
Is there something you're looking for? Like maybe no more than an inch, half an inch?
Inch.
Katase outside to Kekina looking for Okimura, and he's blocked by Andrews and Ma'a, not getting around that.
Well, they're missing Micah Goshi in the back row. Carwalita is taking a timeout. 23-22, Punahou.
Of course, Iolani was the first to 20. They were up 20-17.
Yep.
Punahou clawed their way back to 20-20. And now Punahou just 2 points away from ending the match. Uno, dos, adios, turkey sandwich.
Right. Well, playing in beach volleyball tournaments, you lose once, you lose twice, you go home and cook rice. That's what they always said. But Iolani's got a lot of game left in them, I know that. Taking a look at Pono Nu'uhiva and the Nu'uhiva edition. He can say uncle, by the way, and he's only probably 6 months old. I mean, I don't know. Maybe.
Talking already.
He says uncle. Who do we have here?
Can he say D-set?
Set me the ball. Look at this gentleman. This is the
conductor of our multi-generational
the Marauder
College alumni band.
Wow.
This gang is at everything. I give these guys all kinds of credit for showing up. They're at everything.
They are. My goodness.
This band is at everything.
And they're in rhythm.
There's Thompson with a serve handled by Katase. Kekina trying to punch it over Thompson. Trying to find two in the back row. Handled by Katase. Kekina chasing it down. Looking for Goshi from the back row. That's handled by Tui nicely. Ma'a looking for Tui again. Katase looking for Goshi on the set. One arm dig by Ma'a. Tui from the back row again. Handled by Wong. Kekina. The swing. They're going to call Punahou into the net. And that's a good call.
Ooh.
That was a good call. I think that was a good call.
Rick is explaining that it was not Andrews netting, and it was the middle blocker on Iolani netting. That play was too quick. We have no replay. Rick Toon is still. He's asking us what we saw. They.
You're all even at 23s.
No replay.
Ma'a with a dump over. Very heady play from Micah Ma'a to get the match point.
He's front row setter. He can do that. That's an
They're
offensive.
They're trying to call back row attacker. He's front row.
He's front row.
He's front row. Row.
Yeah, yeah.
They
They're
need to
all
tell
good.
Him, don't just play your match, young man.
24-23. Everybody's
staff.
Right.
Just.
Hey, good to see some energy. It's 12 noon, 12:30. These guys are not going away.
See, Andrew Okimura trying to consult with the up official, the senior up official in Hawaii, Dan Hiranaka. Trying to slow things down a little bit.
Yep.
Punahou at match point. Won the first set 25-21, up 24-23. Set number two, Kupuno Fei into the net. And I'll say the partisan Iolani crowd, because I think Iolani definitely has
a larger
crowd.
We got a lot of fans from Iolani right now. They're pretty fired
here.
Up. 24
well,
all.
Even at 24s, Kyle Kekina.
We want them to go three, I think. You want to go three?
That's what they want.
People behind
live
us.
Live microphones is the Iolani crowd sitting behind us. Kekina with a serve. Reese Ma'a outside to Tui. Down the line. Point to the buff and blue.
He loves that down the line. It's the look away. He shows heavy, heavy angle. And then he does
he
a cross
it.
Court. Pulls that. It's that quarterback arm. Nice pass by Kekoa Reese.
And that's what they say about Tui as a quarterback. He's got that quick release.
Quick release. He's a gamer.
We are match point again for the Buff and Blue. Kekoa Reese with a serve. Ace. And that's an ace. Point set match for the Buff and Blue. 26-24 in game number two. 25-21, 26-24, Tony. Punahou ups their record to 3-1 on the year.
That was a well done game. Iolani, got to give them a lot of credit. They had a match last night
against a very tough Hawaii Baptist Academy
and team. They went down in two. HBA is a great team, and they're coming back to back. Punahou had a little rest, and they just came out on top. I think we're going to be joined.
We're going to go grab Tui
grab Tui Tuileta, and all you guys out there, we appreciate you tuning in to this early edition of 2013 Punavision. Mike Machado, Tony McInerney here, and this is going to be a great season for all in the ILH. Kamehameha had an upset Punahou. Punahou had a nice win tonight against Iolani. So there's parity. There's a lot of parity, and Mike is coming up with right now with Tui. Tui, we're going to ask him a couple questions. Great to see you, young man. Getting mic'd up. First of all, Mike, you got a nice question, I think, for Tui right now.
Yeah, so happy to get out of here with a 2-0 sweep after that tough command man match on Tuesday.
We just got back out of practice, and we came pretty hungry because after that loss, we were all kind of sick, so... we came back, we had three quality practices before we came back into the game, and we're pretty proud of how we did during the practice and it shows.
Well, I mean, there are a number of times in this match where you guys found yourself down a couple, three, 4 points, and it seemed eerily reminiscent in game two of how things went on Tuesday against Kamehameha. How was Coach Rick a little more animated today and trying to keep you guys focused in game two?
Yeah, that was one of the things that we had to practice, because after our first set against Kamehameha, we came out in the second set kind of slow, and that's one of the things during the game that we tried to emphasize in practice, and especially in the game today, and Rick was really good at emphasizing it, and we got on it, and we did well.
You know, Tui, I noticed you started to hit some angle ball in the left side, and then your bread and butter, you love to hit that line shot down the line.
Yeah.
I mean, you thundered one against Kamehameha Tuesday night off somebody's head.
Uh-huh.
And it looks as though that's your go-to shot. Would that be safe to assess? That's your go-to ball?
I guess so. We just really like the matchup on the outside because I had a small blocker.
Smart.
And the tempo is really fast, so when we get a good pass, we want to try and shoot it to the outside and catch the blockers off guard. And sometimes they're too slow to get to the line, and it's just open, so I hit it.
Nicely done.
All right, well, Tui, congratulations on a great win. Any win over Iolani is a good win, right?
Yes, it is a good win.
All right, well, thank you very much, Tui.
And enjoy the junior function, my friend.
Oh, yes.
Enjoy the junior function.
I will.
Thanks for stopping by.
All right. So, Punahou boys volleyball victorious today over the visiting Iolani Raiders, 25-21, 26-24. Punahou in the midst of a bit of a homestand. They had Kamehameha last Tuesday, Iolani today. Coming up next Tuesday, in a non-webcasted match. They have St. Louis Crusaders coming in another home match after that, a week later on the 26th against Marino. But we have a number of webcasts coming up as well. Unfortunately, I didn't write any of this down, but I know we have a few more softball games and water polo games coming up on Puna Vision.
Yes.
Check punahoe.edu/webcast for your schedule. If you want to watch today's match again, go to youtube.com/punavision. Catch today's match and all of Punavision's previous broadcasts logged in there. So with that, I think we will call it a day. T-Mac, good to see you again.
Great match. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in.
All right, and with that, we will call it a day. I'm Mike Machado for Tony McInerney. Until next time, have a good one. Aloha.
Aloha.